Fordi V18 is the fourth version developed with the R-release concept. Some people think this is all about features, but in fact, our main goal was to drastically improve product quality. So let me tell you how it all started. 10 years ago, when 40v13 was just on the market, I talked to a group of large software editors and asked them, what is your number one feature request? Jeff Kane, now head of development for Sweetwater Music, our largest installation worldwide, was quick to say stability. I said that I asked for features, and Jeff replied, features are useless if a product is not stable enough. So I asked for feature number two, and the answer was stability. And all the others in the room agreed. So that became my personal target, the most important need. I was convinced we reached this target with version V16. And my next job was to convince you. And the breakthrough for me was 2018, arriving in the morning in the office and seeing this message in our forum. When Jeff wrote that a .dot version is stable enough to deploy, while he always said before, better to wait for a .4 or even .5, this meant we did our job, mission accomplished. Reaching this target was not only hard work, it required a total change in our processes. From the way we design and specify features, features are developed, tested and deployed. The result was the R-release branch. We have smaller sets of features and, as important, to split a single feature in really small parts, sometimes even over several releases, to allow deep testing of every single aspect of a feature. 40v18 is a milestone. It is our first 64-bit only release. Huge parts of the application were totally rewritten. All used libraries updated, designed for modern operating systems, for Windows 10, and for the future of Apple, which is, as we all know, 64-bit only. With 40v18, we are ready for the next big change in our product release strategy. As today, we keep a 3-month cycle for feature releases. To make it more clear, we name the versions now feature release, keeping the R2 and R3 only as a shortcut. And we introduce a long-term support release, shortcut LTS. This version will have a 24-month release cycle, giving conservative customers more time. LTS versions are designed to have as less changes as possible, to allow to run for a long time without changes. No new features, as less updated libraries as possible, only bug fixes. For libraries, this means we update them in the LTS branch only if there are security reasons. If not, we keep the library unchanged. But in feature releases, we update libraries to get access to new features, such as PHP with 40v17 R5. Or we use new APIs to prepare 4D for new operating systems, especially on Mac. We do a constantly refactoring of our code base, and this work goes into the future release. All this does not happen for LTS versions. That produces less risk for backward compatibility, but also means it might reduce compatibility for future OS releases. So LTS every 24 months, feature release every 3 months. And yes, this means that we now have 8 feature releases, R2 to R8, before introducing the next LTS version, including all its features. To help you planning your own releases and deployments, here's our roadmap. We shipped V18 in January 2020. We will ship V19 in January 2022. And V20 in January 2024, and so on. We will support V18 till December 2022. Similar timeframe for future versions. As you can see, this will give you a calendar year to migrate your customers, while both versions are supported. Depending on your business, you can choose the best time, like spring or summer, or do a slow rollout. Most important, you know upfront when you will need to migrate. Years upfront. You can plan now the migration in 2022. So choose if you want to use LDS versions, use stable for many years, stable set of features, or if you prefer the most modern version, newest features, delivered in a short interval. And now it's time to finally start showing features. Keisuke Miyako from Fortive Japan.